Okay, Charles, what do you think?
About what?
Let's just go through these, the ones that don't have names yet, and give them names. You know, kind of think through what it is that they are like and label them.
Okay, sure, we can do that. All right, so if the first one is a regular MDP, and what makes it a regular MDP is that you're doing an expectation over the next best action that will be taken, right?
Right, the best next action, I would say.
Right, that's right. That's the right way of saying it. So here, the only difference between the second one and the first one is that instead of doing an expectation, you're going to only pay attention to the worst possible state you could get into.
Okay, and so we're taking out the actual stochastic dynamics of the MDP and replacing it with something that is minimizing.
Right. And so that means if we were thinking about the function at the very top, the Q star is not, kind of the value of taking an action in a particular state, given that you're then going to do the best thing from that point on, but it's sort of the value you would get if you sort of always assume the worst thing could happen. And if that were true everywhere, then you would be valuing things by the worst possible outcome. And so that would be a kind of, oh, I don't know what the right word is, maybe something like a pessimistic MDP or a risk averse MDP, something like that.
Ooh, good. Worst case MDP, maybe. It's also related to, in control theory, the notion of H infinity control. The H infinity control basically says, I don't know what's going to happen, so let me assume that the worst thing's going to happen.
So pessimistic sort of describes the outlook on the world of this equation. But is risk averse the right thing? This suggests that I will end up trying to choose ask actions that put me places where the least bad thing could happen.
Well, I mean, I wouldn't quite think of it that way. So it's almost as if the environment is out to get you, right? So instead of just randomly transitioning you to some state, it's always putting you in a state that makes you the least happy of all the states that you could go to.
Oh, so grad school.
Well, it depends where you go to grad school. Like Rhode Island is a pretty good state. All right. So we're going to be placed in a state that is worst for us. And once we get there, then we get to choose an action. We get to choose the action that's best for us. So it's almost also a kind of game. Right, where we get to make a move, and then the environment makes a move, and then we make a move, and then the environment makes a move.
Okay, I like that. I like that. But that means you would want to choose the action that would get you to the place where kind of the least worst thing could happen.
Yeah, that's right. Right. So the me us, the agent, the ones who's doing the deciding, is trying to be risk averse relative to what the environment might do to it.
Right, sure. That makes perfect sense. Okay. So risk averse is not a bad description.
Good. So other answers that I would accept for here include things like adversarial dynamics or two-player game, things like that. I guess you could also notice the way that this is written here. This is the min over all next states. So this is really going to always transition us to the worst state, not the worst state that makes any sense, because we didn't do something like for all states in the set of states that are reachable with probability greater than zero, right? That's a little bit more constrained. We didn't constrain it. So really, it could just be an MDP that makes you sit in the in the worst possible place and just pummels you over and over again. But I don't think there's a nice succinct name for that.
I thought that was pretty succinct what you said.
All right, good.